The World Health Organization reported today that the Ebola virus has now killed more than 2,800 people in West Africa. The majority of deaths have been in Liberia, Guinea, and Sierra Leone. But the deadly illness has been relatively contained in nearby and much larger Nigeria, which counts 21 cases and only 9 deaths. Tonight, special correspondent Fred de Sam Lazaro takes a look at how Nigeria has controlled Ebola spread. Fred's reporting is a partnership with the Undertold Stories Project at St. Mary's University of Minnesota.
Not much moves in a hurry in Nigeria's commercial capital, Lagos, also Africa's most populous city. And basic services like roads and covered sewers have yet to reach slums like Otumara. But the Ebola message has. What it is, where to report it, how to prevent it.
You need to wash your hands. It is very, very important for you.
Nigeria's Ebola response has been comprehensive in communities and the media. There's temperature screening at all the country's entry and exit points. Fever is an early warning sign. And extensive surveillance by public health workers. It's driven by sound epidemiology and the American consul in Lagos, Jeffrey Hawkins, says, fear.
One thing that people really don't want to hear is Ebola and Lagos in the same sentence. This is a city of 20 million people, and a major urban outbreak here could have been apocalyptic. But the response was quick.
One early leader of that response was Babangida Fashola, governor of Lagos State, which includes the city.
On this kind of job, fear is always healthy. If you lose fear, something is wrong.
Nigeria's response began soon after the first confirmed Ebola case in late July. A Liberian-American traveler fell ill at the airport in Lagos. His circle of contacts was limited to the health workers who cared for him, and then there were their contacts. One of them carried the infection to the southern city of Port Harcourt, causing a second outbreak.
Within a question of just a few days, we had as many as 500 contacts that were being traced just to cast a wide net and ensure that anybody that has potentially had any contact with a case, you know, is under our purview, you know, taking temperatures, asking them if they have any symptoms.
Dr. Faisal Shuaib of Nigeria's health ministry heads the Ebola command center.
Everybody has a copy of the action tracker.
The response team includes several international agencies that have been in Nigeria for years fighting other diseases, like malaria, HIV, and polio. They quickly redeployed. Dr. Nancy Knight with the U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention says the CDC had earlier trained many field epidemiologists here.
One of the things that's really helped to keep the fear in check and to keep it from turning into, you know, widespread panic has been the number of boots on the ground. We've had between Lagos and Port Harcourt more than 1,000 people that have been working on containing the epidemic.
Despite Nigeria's many problems, sectarian violence, Boko Haram insurgents kidnapping schoolgirls, the country has a more developed public health system than its smaller neighbors reeling from Ebola. Having international experts on hand also helped reassure key political leaders like Lagos's governor.
That helped a lot to make decisions and to communicate with all of the stakeholders, religious leaders, primary healthcare workers, school teachers, to reassure them that we could turn this around.
The aid group Doctors Without Borders has trained health workers on handling patients, on using the airtight personal protective equipment. The group has built isolation centers in Lagos and Port Harcourt that would handle a fresh outbreak. For now, there's just one suspected case left.
There's no panic, but there's still a lot of stigma surrounding Ebola in Nigeria. As outsiders, as a camera crew, we weren't allowed to go near contact tracers. These are public health workers who fan out each day to keep tabs on people who had any contact with someone infected with Ebola.
Dennis Akaga knows firsthand about stigma.
I lost the job while I was taking care of Justina.
And he lost Justina, his fiancée, who was 2 months pregnant. On her first day on a new job, The 32-year-old nurse's first patient just happened to be that first Ebola case, the Liberian-American. Akaga, too, became infected, but he pulled through. Survivors of Ebola become immune and are no longer contagious, but that hasn't helped Dennis Akaga.
Ebola is now a death sentence. I wouldn't have lost my job if they had been informed.
Early detection has helped the survival rate in Nigeria. Fewer than half the cases have resulted in death. But the stigma only worsens the public health threat, says Dr. Dadil Nasir Waziri, who heads the contact tracing effort.
A lot of contacts that were under follow-up couldn't even come out to get food in their communities because they were being stigmatized. So that's a big worry because that will make people to hide.
Washing of our hands regularly is one of the best ways to avoid and prevent all of these diseases flying around, like Ebola. Huh?
Nigeria's influential film industry, popularly called Nollywood, has stepped in to help.
This is like, you know, like UFO, you know, it's only descended on Nigeria, you know, and we have to do something about it, you know.
Tunde Kalani, a top director, says Nollywood's leading lights came together in record time, responding, he says, to the biggest existential threat anyone here has felt.
I think they responded very well because we put together a list of about 18 of the celebrities.
Now he's thinking, why not expand the idea beyond this lens on Ebola effort?
For instance, we can do lens on polio. We can do lens on malaria.
Ebola no day for Harand.
In the distressed Otamara neighborhood, Alaja Jato is also thinking beyond Ebola.
But she said she has something to tell the government. That they don't have pipe-borne water. That their roads are bad.
Whether the government delivers on those improvements is unclear, but the Ebola campaign will continue and on high alert. That's even though the number of contacts being tracked is now down to about 300. Each day, more people cross the critical 21 days since their exposure to the virus, the window in which symptoms can occur. Ironically, this success is a worry. Dr. Faisal Schwab fears Nigeria could attract Ebola patients from nearby countries like Sierra Leone, Liberia, and Guinea.
We've had, you know, record levels of people surviving Ebola virus disease, and they might start feeling, well, maybe this is the place to come.
The UN has called Ebola a threat to global security, and many people here say Nigeria, the regional economic hub, a nation of 170 million, will remain the most vulnerable frontier.